Can you guess what's the problem with this code? If you live in a Western country, there's a good chance this code seems perfectly reasonable. We format the full name of the user by using string interpolation. However, while most Western countries indeed format a full name by writing the given name first and the family name second, not all countries follow this convention. For instance, Koreans write the family name first and the given name second. And as you can imagine, if your app doesn't follow this local convention, it will feel weird and out of place with a part of your audience. Fortunately, iOS has a built-in way to solve this problem. We're going to use a class called PersonNameComponentsFormatter. PersonNameComponentsFormatter works in a similar way to other formatters like NumberFormatter or DateFormatter. You give it raw data and it formats it according to the user's locale. So I'm going to update the implementation of the property fullname to use a PersonNameComponentsFormatter rather than string interpolation. As you can see, the new implementation yields the same result than the previous one. That's normal because my locale is currently set to French, and this is indeed how a full name would be displayed in France. But if I update the locale to be that of Korea, you can see that the behavior of the formatter is now matching that of the new locale. The full name is now formatted with the family name first and the given name second. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed discovering how Person Name Components Formatter works. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.